station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Leah Cheshire. This week, senior advisor to the president, Ivanka Trump, visited Johnson Space Center to tour key human spaceflight facilities and meet with students. During her visit, Ms. Trump and NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine toured a mock-up of the space station and NASA's Orion spacecraft. She also met local high school students working with NASA engineers to build a robot for the first robotics competition. While visiting the International Space Station Flight Control Room, Ms. Trump spoke with astronauts currently on board.
Do you have anything you want to share with us about your experience at the International Space Station as astronauts?
I'd say our message is pretty consistent. We all believe in what we're doing up here. We think it's important to the continuation of the human species, and also the science that we're doing in space is all really designed to make life better on Earth and allow us to be better as people as we take care of the planet and also move out into the solar system.
Astronauts on the space station checked out their spacesuits in preparation for some outside exploration. NASA astronauts Serena Anand-Chancellor and Drew Feustel joined European Space Agency astronaut Alexander Gerst to inspect spacesuits ahead of upcoming spacewalks. The astronauts ensured the correct sizing of the suits, which will be used when they venture outside of the Quest airlock to upgrade batteries on the space station's truss structure. Visit our website for launch schedule updates and to watch live. This week's question is about the upcoming spacewalks, specifically what will happen to the old batteries once they're switched out. Just like old batteries in your household items, these will be disposed. The lithium-ion batteries being delivered on the Japanese cargo vehicle will replace 12 nickel-hydrogen batteries on the port truss. Once the swaps are complete, 9 of the older batteries will be stored in the Japanese cargo vehicle to be disposed of in the atmosphere upon re-entry. The remaining 3 will be stored on the station's truss permanently, but not as spares. After the upcoming spacewalks to replace the batteries are completed, 4 of 8 power channels on the station will have been upgraded with the new batteries. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag Space2Ground. We'll see you next week.